Advance is the equivalent of magic or intelligence in other Souls games, and it's also one of the three stats within Lies of P that determine the overall strength of your character. Advance increases your defense against many status effects, but it also boosts your own elemental output. Advance builds are one of the best options for Lies of P, especially during your first playthrough, since you'll be increasing the power of your status effects, which deal additional damage over time after hitting an enemy. This can be especially useful for wearing down tough enemies or disrupting actions. Welcome back, everyone. Thank you so much for clicking on the video. Today we are breaking down one of the best Lies of P advanced fire builds. This guide will discuss the best stats, weapon, legion arm, P organ, and amulets to use. If you find this video useful and want to see more Lies of P build guides, we cover all things action RPG on this channel, so if it sounds like the place for you, consider subscribing to the channel. We would love to have you here. Advanced builds in Lies of P rely on advanced scaling weapons that do both physical and elemental damage. Those who want to specialize in advance will discover that their choices of weapons are actually pretty diverse, similar to technique builds, with some emphasis on switching out weapon parts for the best combinations. I used this advanced build for my entire first playthrough, and I even beat the final boss in the game using this exact build that I'm sharing with you all today. Advanced builds are more than capable of destroying even the toughest enemies in Lies of P, especially enemies that are weak against fire. Aside from your weapon, you also have the Flamberge Legion Arm, which deals fire damage and can be very useful against a group of enemies since you can fire it while walking backwards. It's not as effective against some bosses, but it does deal a lot of damage to mobs. Fire does damage over time, so you can quickly take out this Legion Arm to apply the debuff and destroy your enemies. The main stats you want to prioritize on this build is Vitality, which is your total health, Vigor, which controls your stamina. The higher your Vigor, the more stamina you'll have at your disposal to chain attacks, run, and even dodge. Capacity is also very important since it controls your equipment load, and if you want to equip some of the heavier, more powerful amulets or defensive parts, you'll need to get this to at least 20. The last and most important stat to prioritize is Advance. The higher this stat is, the more damage you will deal with your advanced scaling weapons, but your status effects will also be more effective. The main weapon on this build is the Black Steel Cutter. The blade type is considered a great sword, so if you're a fan of those types of weapons, you're going to love the Black Steel Cutter. This weapon originally comes with A-tier scaling for Advance, but you can actually achieve S-tier scaling if you apply an advanced crank to the handle. You can see here 134 physical attack power and 211 fire attack power. The first Fable art is called Storm Slash, which lets you slash your enemies multiple times, dealing massive amounts of damage. The other Fable art is Guard Parry. Time the enemy's attack correctly and deflect it to trigger a powerful attack. I also want to share some Black Steel Cutter combo moves that I personally use and also highly recommend for those of you that want to be as effective as possible. The first combo actually starts with a charged heavy attack, but can be seamlessly transitioned into a light attack, allowing you to continue the combo depending on your stamina bar. The next combo is basically just three light attacks followed by a charged heavy attack, and you'll notice that this charged attack is different than the one compared to earlier. With this one, you do a 360 spin with your sword and can attack all enemies surrounding you. And for the last combo, you do have to be running for this one, but whenever you surprise attack an enemy or just play super aggressive, you'll sprint at them and start the combo with a running charged heavy attack, followed by a regular heavy attack, light attack, and then finish it off with a charged heavy. The Black Steel Cutter can be found in Chapter 8, right near the Hermit's Cave Stargazer. Once you spawn at the Stargazer, make your way down the ladder and across the bridge. The chest containing the Black Steel Cutter is being guarded by a powerful enemy, so come prepared. For the Legion Arm, your best choice is going to be the Flamberge Legion Arm. the perfect choice for a fire-focused build. This Legion arm has A-tier scaling for advance, and is amazing for clearing mobs fast and just applying damage over time to bosses. The more points you invest in advance, the more effective your Flambeur's Legion arm will be. All Legion arm upgrades are worth grabbing as soon as you can for this one. Wave of Fire increases the attack range of your fire, which is helpful when you're fighting against deadlier enemies with reach. Strengthened Combustion enhances fire after a certain time upon a continuous fire attack, so the longer you use your Legion arm, the more effective the fire will be. And lastly, Flame Explosion, which unleashes an explosion after firing your Legion arm for a certain amount of time. For the amulets, I recommend using the Iron Wall amulet, which increases your physical damage reduction rate. This is going to compensate for the survivability that you might be losing depending on which defensive parts you equip. I also have the blue guardianship amulet, which increases max HP, stamina, and legion all at the same time. This is one of the best amulets in Lies of P. And lastly, we have the transformation amulet, which adds +4 advance to the build, taking my 36 advance and increasing it to 40. For the P organs, the first ability you're going to want to grab is Link Dodge. Mobility is extremely important in this game, and it's actually a big part of this build. I started off by enhancing the stagger attack of my charge attacks. This is going to make it easier to break an enemy's guard. I also added a skill here which lowers the damage I receive when dodging, which is incredibly useful when you want to avoid getting one-shotted. You should also increase your pulse cells whenever you can. Lies of P is a pretty difficult game, and it's actually very punishing. For this one, I added the increased stagger duration 1, which increases the window of time you have to break an enemy's stance and deal massive amounts of damage. And I also grabbed this one here, which increases ergo upon eliminating an enemy. After that, you'll unlock phase 2, and then you'll want to grab Rising Dodge, which will increase your mobility even further. This skill lets you dodge enemy attacks when you're on the ground. I can't tell you how many times this has saved my life. Next, I added a skill here that enhances your weapon attack when durability is at maximum, and a defensive skill which lowers damage taken during charge attacks and when using Fable Arts. Charge attacks deal massive amounts of damage, especially with the Black Steel Cutter, and you want to make sure you have as much survivability as possible when executing these attacks. Next, grab Increased Pulse Cell 2 and add the offensive skill, which enhances weapon attack when pulse cells are discharged, and also the skill that lowers your stamina consumption when using pulse cells. This helps a lot in those close call situations, especially when you're really close to dying. I didn't grab any skills in phase 3 just because they didn't offer much for this build, so I went ahead and went back to phase 2 so I can increase my amulet slots. This was a great opportunity to increase the maximum number of pulse cells on the build, and also unlock the ability to fully charge our Fable bar whenever we come back from death. I also unlocked Retain Guard Regain 1 in Phase 2, and was able to increase the stagger attack of charge attacks using Enhanced Charge Stagger Attack 2, and Lower Guard Regain Reduction using Lower Guard Regain Reduction 2. This will eventually unlock Phase 4, where you can unlock Perfect Guard Cause Stiffness, which breaks the enemy's stance when a perfect guard is successful. I took this opportunity to increase Pulse Cell maximum number uses even further, unlock the ability to charge Legion whenever eliminating an enemy, which is huge. This also eliminates the need for Legion magazines. And lastly, unlocked an ability that reduces the amount of natural HP recovery when attacking an enemy with a weapon. This is essentially slowing down the time it takes for an enemy to get their health back. After that, I went back to phase 1 so I could increase the effectiveness of charge attacks even further by increasing the time an enemy is staggered for. From here, I decided to enhance the attack power of my Fable Arts, which is helpful considering Storm Slash is a very powerful ability on the Black Steel Cutter, and then further decrease my overall damage received when pulse cells are discharged. My next step is to add more Legion arm slots to the build so I can switch to the puppet string in the middle of combat, but so far I've increased my stagger duration, increased the maximum number of pulse cells, giving me a total of 10 pulse cells on the build, and also added the ability to automatically charge consumed Legion. This concludes today's video for the best Lies of P advance build. Thank you all so much for being here and watching my video. If you found this video helpful and want to see more videos like this one reach more people, please leave a thumbs up, I would appreciate it so much. If you want to see more Lies of P videos and action RPG videos overall, subscribe to the channel, we would love to have you here.